Thanks to everyone who have subscribed. If you have not, please do. And thanks for coming out here. I really appreciate you.
Edo polls. INEC lists election offenses and their penalties. Hey, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time we're reaching you today. Thank you so much for being there. We really appreciate you. God bless you. Yes, yeah, so INEC has, the chairman of INEC is in Edo State on ground now as we speak. I don't know if he's going to be there all the way for the next 22 days to the election, but he was there. He came to see the Oba of Benin and was asked questions and their preparedness. And last night we intimated you with an information saying that they have even released air forces into Edo State. We don't know if Edo State is at war or it's just an election. However, they have released a list of election offenses and the penalties that we go alongside with it. It is important we listen to this list, we know them, so that we don't fall victim or prey, or anyone around us do not become a victim of these offenses. So guys, we're just going to go straight into the news so that you can get all the details. Edo polls, INEC lists election offenses and their penalties. With the Edo State governorship election less than 3 weeks away, aimed at growing fears of violence, the Independent National Electoral Commission is taking no stern unturned in its present pursuit for a free, fair, and peaceful election. INEC has listed conduct that must and may run afoul of the Electoral Act, and the penalties declaring its determination applies to the law strictly. This is as the coalition of civil society group Yega Africa says that from its survey, the September 19 election may be marked by strong tactics, violence, and voters being not given the opportunity to do the right thing. In a ballot released by the weekend, INEC reading the Riot Act of the parties gave a list of conducts that will not be conducted, that must not be conducted during the election, and the penalty for such if anyone is found wanting of these offenses. Clearly evident that from the Electoral Act, INEC stated that Section 23A and D of the law frown on unlawful possession or selling or buying of voter card, saying the penalty for the offense is 2 years imprisonment or 500,000 naira fine. So you heard that one. No buying or selling of voters card. If you are caught, you said 2 years imprisonment or you pay 500,000 naira. Next, let's continue. INEC said in Section 59 of the Electoral Act, anyone impersonating voter should be arrested and prosecuted for an offense of impersonation under the law applicable in the state and the Electoral Act. So the next one, now you've heard it too. So there are some people that will come and say, you are Janet, you are Janet, but you come and say, I'm Usaze. Mm-hmm. If you are caught, persecution. Continue. Section 124, subsection 1 of the Electoral Act says to deal with bribery of any officials or security officials. Anyone found wanting will be jailed for 1 year or fined 500,000 naira fine or both. So if you are seen wanting to bribe an official, you'll be jailed for 1 year or fine of 500,000 naira, or you'll be given both to do. According to INEC, Section 125 of the Electoral Act, that anyone spying to know who a person votes for is to be jailed for 6 months or make to pay a fine of 100,000 naira. So if they catch you, you'll pay. A spy who want to know, it's supposed to be secret who you vote for. Section 127, subsection 1, the act of specifying that voters or trying to vote a person not registered is an offense, collaborated in Section 127, subsection 2, and a person should be jailed for 6 months and fined 100,000 naira if found guilty of the offense. INEC says Section 128 of the Electoral Act adds that acting or inciting others to be disobedient in a disobedient manner, saying it's an offense punishable with 1 year imprisonment or a fine of 500,000 naira. While Section 129 states that campaign bearing of sirens within 30 meters of a polling unit on an election day is an offense under Section 129 with a jail term of 6 months or a fine of 100,000 naira. Furthermore, INEC says that under Section 129, Subsection 1 of the Act, the destruction of electoral materials or snatching of electoral materials constitutes an offense as stated in Section 129, Subsection 4, with 1 year jail without an option of fine. INEC also addressed the issue of underage or multiple voting, explained that anyone found wanting here should be jailed for 12 months or fined 500,000 naira or both. But Yegua Africa, in a report by its executive director, Samson Itodo, identified those that could influence the credibility of the governorship section to include INEC and other stakeholders, including the security agencies, court, and domestic observers. Of the five institutes that could influence the credibility and the outcome of Edo governorship election, responsibility and response and explain the highest level of trust in the military, 56%, followed by the electoral observers, 53% by the courts, 48% by INEC, and finally the polls, 39%. It states that regardless of the opinion and the options, it must be kept. Yega Africa stated that voters, apart from also being enlightened in Edo State during the 2016 election and 2019 global national election, where only 32% of the 35% respectively of the registered voters cast their vote, why in the COVID-19 pandemic he loomed claims that insecurity is lapped on the September 19 election. There is overwhelming concern about the stakeholders that registered voters in Edo may not be ready as at when time due. According to the report, 94% of the Edo residents in our survey identified themselves as registered voters. Among the registered voters, approximately 7 in 10 reports being very likely to vote in the September 19 election, and a further 14% somewhat likely when combined to an overall majority of registered voters in the 85% are entirely accounted that may vote in the governorship election. A deep examination of the results indicates that men are almost 10 points more likely to be strong and ready to vote than we men coming out. Well, my people, so that's INEC stating out what they will do, plans they will take, and what the plans are for the election. So this is what it is. We'd like to hear your view. God bless you.